shit, I'm funny, bro.
Who says that? Okay, I do that all the time. I'm funny as hell.
Hey, all right, man. So, if you're watching this right now, this is May 11th. That's exactly 13 days after the one-year anniversary of this show that you're watching right now.
Basically, a year and 2 weeks.
Yeah. So, this has been an entire year and 2 weeks of us consistently putting out... Yo, this went by fast, actually. I feel like a year. Like, when you say, like, oh, I've been doing that for a year, sounds like a long time. It's really not. Like, I feel like it haven't been doing this long at all. Which I guess is a good thing, because it's more of, like, a, I guess, like, a natural... Like,
yeah, like, we're enjoying it, so we're not feeling like a burden.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like, you know, like, oh, fuck, like, I gotta go ahead. You know what I'm saying? Which is crazy. But, you know... I honestly, like, in a serious sense, now, I actually want to take this time, though, because I've, in this year, this is what I've learned so far. You know, a lot of people ponder onto starting something because they're thinking too much about what other people are going to think, right? And the biggest challenge isn't what camera you're going to get, what setup you're going to have, what are you going to say. The biggest challenges I think I found is really breaking down your content. You know what I mean? Like, whatever it is that you want to talk about or put out or whatever, how can you make that better? How can you break it down to attract other people? Mm-hmm. I guess, like, a more marketing type of thing. Like, what are the things that you can do to improve, and what's the vision that you have for this that you want to do, right? And is that thing that you want to do actually something that you want to do? You know what I mean? Like, and by that I mean, like, you know, some people get too caught up, you know what I'm saying, in watching, like, other people's success in certain things that they feel like, oh, well, I could do that too. And then you realize, like, you don't really like that. You know what I'm saying? So, for example, there's, like, a lot of successful vloggers. There's a lot of successful sneaker people reviewers and clothes reviewers and stuff like that. And, you know, certain people just feel like, oh, well, they're doing this. They're getting money. I might as well just go ahead and do it. And your interest might not really be, you know what I'm saying, into that. You know what I'm saying? So, for me, man, and... I guess, like, the message that I have for you guys is going to be, yo, whatever it is that you want to start, just get to it. You know what I'm saying? Because the challenges are in it. You know what I'm saying? The challenges are not when you're looking outside and, like, you don't know. The challenges are when they're in there. You know what I mean? When you have a video that stopped on you while you were talking for, like, an hour. You know what I'm saying? And you just lost an hour worth of, like, genuine conversation. You know what I'm saying? The tips and things, you know what I'm saying?
Like, having to upload videos, having to edit whatever, having to think of ideas.
Exactly. Like, that's, you know, even when you're draining, you know, you have to, like, do it. Like, there's been times where we've done the podcast, like, done tired. Like, it was like, fuck, like.
But we gotta do it. We gotta push through.
Yeah, we gotta push through. Exactly. The mentality is just to be as consistent as we can and push out as much as we can. So, after a year, I think I've learned that, you know, starting is probably the easiest part. People usually say it's the hardest. Mm-hmm. It's probably the easiest part. It's probably the hardest emotional part. But you know, once you're in it, the struggles are just gonna be on how can you be better. Consistent. And can you continue? That's the most important part. Can you continue to do it? You know what I'm saying? Regardless of, you know what I'm saying, like, what's going on. You know, because, like, for that, like, it's been a year, and again, like I said, man, I'm amazed that we get listeners, that we get views, all of that stuff. You know what I'm saying? Because some people might have gave up by now. You know what I mean? Some people might have been like, nah, I only have 59 subscribers. We only have 3 views on the video. We only have 1 view here. Like, no, like, I can't do this. What's the point? You know what I'm saying? And then, because your whole thing was trying to blow up or something like that. You know what I mean? So you need, again, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, you need to have the right reasons for doing what it is that you want to do. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, it has to be something that you enjoy thoroughly. You know what I'm saying? It can't be like, oh, well, if I didn't get X amount of likes, or I don't have X amount, I'm not gonna do it. Well, then there's probably something that you shouldn't be pursuing to begin with. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I think you have to have the right, like, time exposes your motives. Now, we've been saying since the beginning, since the first episode.
Say that again. Time exposes your motives.
Yeah,
I like that.
Because you can say from the beginning, you know, I really want to inspire the world, right? Or I want to change the world. But if it gets hard and you quit, then you really didn't want to change the world that much. You want to change your own world, right? But, you know, our motive, our thing has said, man, even if one person is listening, right, and this in some way made you laugh when you're going through a tough time, or made you, you know, reflect on something and think differently, or open your eyes to a different way, or encourage you to do something you're passionate about, or to do something and fail and then find out you didn't like it. If any of those things happen, or something along those lines happen, or if it just entertained you while you were driving, if any of that happened and one person listened, we were honored. So we are, we have 59 plus reasons to be honored to just keep doing this. And so obviously, and I've said it from the beginning, for us, this is just an, like, you get a view into our daily conversations anyways, because we're going to have these conversations. Mm-hmm. But for me, I'm Down has been like that push to really, like, tell myself, what have I wanted to do or didn't know I wanted to do that I haven't done, right? And one of those things has been, you know, finding routines that are consistent. Like, I think we've been going to the gym now for how long consistently? Well, you've been going for your life, but I've been going for now almost a year too.
Almost
a year now. Yeah. So consistently adding that to my routine, you know, and that includes, I don't eat super healthy by any means, right? Because I love chocolate and cookies and stuff. But that includes, you know, also reducing some other things that were not as beneficiary to my life, right? You know, taking better choices, being more, you know, but also being more, I guess, exposed to different culture. Because we had food from so many different countries in the last year, bro. Yeah, just because I'm like, yo, let's try this place. And you're like, I'm down. Yeah. And, you know, we've done a bunch of different things. So to me, I'm Down has been the best thing that's ever happened, because it's pushed me to say I don't have a reason to doubt, you know. Like, just go out and do it. If you fail, it's really not failing. It's just learning a lesson, right, in a hard way. And those usually last better, longer, and more impactful than the ones you learn in an easy way. So, yeah, man. So, we're honored. We're thankful. I'm very grateful for just this platform. You know, YouTube is kind of dope. The fact that people can blow up from here, can find business here. But the fact that, you know, you can stumble upon this video from two random dudes, and maybe you like it. Maybe you don't like it. Maybe you disagree with some of the stuff we say, because we say a lot of dumb things all the time. And it's dope because we get to connect. But it's been a learning experience. And I think the most important thing is that is be consistent, because time will expose what this was all about in the first place. All right. So for us, we hope that we can be a light in your darkness, that we can be an encouragement to you. We can be reflection. We can be laughter. We can be something. Right. Or we can be nothing. Absolutely nothing. You listen to it once and we're still honored. You took 2 seconds, 3 seconds. You didn't like our voice or our accents. You left. Yep. But just the fact that you took a second to even ponder, what are they doing? That is an honor. And our encouragement to you guys is be down to live your life. Don't let it go by. Don't be worried about comparison or about, you know, I should be here at 25. I should be here at 30. No, man. You are where you are right now. And that's all you know. After that, just pursue life, because life unfolds and unravels in a beautiful tapestry of life itself. Right? Time isn't guaranteed, so don't waste it. Don't throw it away. That's all we're about, literally. Mm-hmm. Just live your life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. That can be better said. So, you know, I'm down. That should be the motto for your life. I'm down. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time. Peace.